Hello guys, and I'm happy to welcome you back again to my Eurovision channel, Just ESC Analyst. After I took a look at the Cypriot entry in the previous video, now I'm super excited to take a look at the Greek one. So this year, Greece will be represented by Marina Satti. Well, not Marina Diamantis, which maybe many of us are craving for since last 10 or 15 years. But Marina Satti is actually a well-established artist in Greece. She is 37, turned 37 just 2 months ago. She's born in Athens in the family of Sudanese Arab father and a Greek mother. So she likes to combine in her songs a bit of more Arabic flavor with the Greek flavor and with the urban music. Marina had a couple of successful singles and albums throughout the last years. I still remember how a few years ago I was listening a lot to her song called Mantissa. I'm super curious what she brought on stage. I really expect some very cool Greek-influenced urban bop song, or at least maybe like mid-tempo. I definitely don't expect any ballad from Marina Satti. And the song is called Zari, and it's composed by lots of Greek people whom we have never heard about, which is great because we of course see a lot of songs being composed by the same Swedish, Norwegian people every year. And it's great that Greece is bringing something local, something unique. So I'm very much looking forward to react to Zari. So we will take a look at the official music video of the Greek entry, because Greece had just an internal selection where they picked Marina Satti as their lead singer, and then they had another round of selection to choose the best possible song for her. And let's see if Zari is really groundbreaking, if it's what I would expect from Marina Satti or not. Let's dive in. This sounds like introduction to some Greek movie, you know, some about some crazy Greek wedding or whatever. It feels, because she's also, you know, not singing and so on, it feels like it's just an intro to the actual song. I wouldn't expect that this is a part of the real song, but let's see. Well, this is even less of what I would have expected from Marina Satti. This sounds to me like purely like Bollywood music, you know, like it comes straight from India, not from Greece. But yeah, interesting. At least it's in Greek language, I would expect, not in Hindu. Well, now it sounds definitely more like Marina Satti. I'm slightly confused, not only by the music flow, because like the beginning part sounded to me like some classical Greek song from Greek movies. Then it was like Bollywood, and now the actual song comes. I'm not sure this India-style singing was part of the song or not. We will have to see, but maybe it was. But why do we see now advertisement of feta cheese, which is definitely incredible, don't get me wrong, but how does it relate to the song? Athens top 12 places with tour guide. Okay, interesting. Let's continue.
για να πιαστώ. Κάβω τη χαπώνω για σένα κρυφό. Τα αφήνω όλα να βγουνε, πάμε put your hands up. Κάνω ότι δεν ήταν ψέμα. Ρίξε άλλη μια τελευταία φορά. Και σε μένα μας φέρει ό,τι θέλει μετά. Τα, 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 τα.
Lovely beat, yeah, really incredible, great fusion of like urban style, but definitely you can feel that it comes from the southeast, you know, Greece, or it could be also maybe Turkey, if it wouldn't be in Greek language. You know, I don't see those cultural differences maybe as much as people from that region. But the music video is super confused, and I'm not sure what is the story behind. Why is she now in the kitchen of some presumably Greek restaurant and dancing after eating some whatever souvlaki or whatever it was? Well, I love this integration of, you know, like light rap element, like a bit of R&B. I think this is something what really doesn't get enough representation in Eurovision. Well, for clear reasons, you know, that's not maybe what Eurovision fandom loves the most, maybe not the most accessible music. However, I think it's underestimated. You know, Kalush Orchestra has shown us that even with all this rap and so on, you can even win Eurovision. Yes, they were from Ukraine. It was a special situation. But if the song would be really hated by people, people wouldn't vote for it, even if it comes from Ukraine. What a lovely transition to the head voice here. I love it. I'm not sure what's going on, what is it about, but it's very innovative. If with this ta, 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 if they bring some, you know, memorable dance which people can, you know, replicate and so on, I think it could really bring an amazing result to Greece this year. Okay, again, this Bollywood style head voice singing. Well, if it comes again, I would assume in the beginning it was also part of the song. It is interesting, you know, especially if people like Bollywood music, it might also get some additional votes based on that. However, her voice here sounds a bit high-pitched, so it's also maybe not for everyone. But it's a nice addition to the song. And can I just stop and say how beautiful she is? Yeah, what an amazing woman. Okay, I really have to read what is it about. Why is this man there? Is he related even to her? Who is he? What is he representing? Super confused. Oh, this male backing vocal. I'm not sure if it's a choir or just one person. It's a beautiful addition to the song. I think they should have utilized already from the beginning of the song. It's really, giving additional drive, because it felt at some points slightly empty. But this really fills up the whole thing. Love it.
Da, da.
Wow, this was it. Yeah, you know, this is what we all love Eurovision for, this kind of absolutely unique songs which you wouldn't ever hear on the radio, you know, if you turn it on here in Germany or UK, US, whatever. Yeah, incredible entry. I have quickly taken a look at the lyrics of the song to see what this full music video could be about. The lyrics are actually just about love, you know, that we need to take risks sometimes. The song is actually called Dice, Zari's Dice. So it's about the fact that we are kind of throwing the dice and seeing where it goes in the love life. So the music video actually had nothing to do with the, with what we have heard in the song, but the music video seems to be made to promote slightly Greek tourism, and maybe it's also kind of Marina's artistic interpretation of what the Greek music video for Eurovision should be like. I found it entertaining. Did it make me want to go to Athens as soon as possible? Maybe not, but I appreciate that it's different. You know, it stands out because of this. I would be surprised if they can utilize a lot of things from this music video on Eurovision stage. On Eurovision stage, of course, you could just show all these videos in the background on the screen, but that's not the best formula, in my opinion. I have heard that the talented Greek stage director, Mr. Evangelinos, will take care of this entry, so I'm pretty sure it will be more like slick, classic, solid Eurovision stage and nothing groundbreaking, even though with the song I feel like you could try something more innovative. Greece will take part in the first half of the second semifinal, among the countries like Albania, Armenia, Austria. So we can see that in the second semifinal, there are some countries which usually tend to vote for Greece. There is unfortunately no Cyprus, but Georgia, Armenia, Albania, these are all kind of friends of Greece in some way in the last year. So the countries which tend to support Greece. So I don't think that this is a bad draw for Greece per se, even though it's the first half. So let's take a look maybe at the Greek records in the last 15 years and the last 5 years. So first of all, let's talk about the last 15 years. You can see that Greece is the third most successful country from all the 31 semifinalists this year in the last 15 years. That's an incredible result. They're second in the semifinal. Because they won their semifinals basically in 2008, 2010, 2011, they finished second in 2013. They had an incredible record in Eurovision history. The only time before the last 5 years where they didn't qualify in accordance with the popular televote result was 2016. It was the song, I think, in this Pontic language or something like this. Also kind of like urban mixed with ethno sounds, but it didn't really work. But I think we should not compare it to Zari. It's a completely different story. But in the last 5 years, we can see how Greece ended up falling from this third place, while they had actually the best semifinal score in their first 5 years of the dual semifinal system. Now they fell to the 19th place. And even in this kind of weak second semifinal, they ranked just 9th. This is not such a great streak for Greece. However, we can see that in the last years, they were always borderline qualifiers, like 8th, 9th, 10th place. Only last year, 2023, they were out. But I think Viktor Varnikos just was unfortunately not experienced enough for the Eurovision stage. And I don't think he got enough support also from the broadcaster to bring amazing staging and so on. It really felt like he was kind of left alone there. Yeah, yeah, we see the result. I think with Marina Satti, it will not be the case. She's an experienced artist who was on multiple tours among Europe, visiting lots of countries, performing on bigger and smaller stages. She should be able to show us that Greece is a country we should definitely remember and think about when we think about the favorites of upcoming contests, like it was between 2008 and 2011, at least. Now let's take a look what bookmakers and Eurovision fandom think about the song. In accordance with the bookmakers' betting odds, Greece is currently at place 14. So it seems like it's not really in a race to win this year, at least in accordance with bookmakers. Of course, surprises might happen. We all remember Kate Miller-Heidke and a lot of other artists who, approximately from this, you know, area, from betting odds, just jump towards top three at some point of time based on their live performances. It still kind of shows that we should expect to see Greece in the final this year. At this moment, I don't have doubts about that. We might see a huge disaster with their live performance, but knowing how talented and how experienced Marina Satti is and her team who is behind the performance in Malmö, I really would bet on her qualifying to the final, at least. And now let's take a look at the Eurovision scoreboard. Currently, from 33 selected songs, Greece is on place 7. Wow, that's a great result for Greece. I don't remember seeing Greece so high in the recent years. Therefore, I think we can have high hopes for Marina in Malmö. Wow, we have heard just 3 songs for the upcoming contest, and they're all incredible in some way. Belgium with its dark energy, super powerful explosion in the end of the song. Cyprus with this summer bob, which is a perfect fit for the song contest in May. And now Greece with this very innovative mixture of ethno and urban elements in one song. Which one do you think will do the best in Eurovision? What do you think? Will this song, Zari, bring the best result to Greece in their last 10 years or so? Please let me know down below in the comments, and hopefully see you in the next video.